नमस्कार दोस्तों, कैसे हैं आप लोग? उम्मीद करता हूँ आप लोग सब ठीक होंगे। मेरा नाम है डॉक्टर नीरज एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट डर्बिन वॉटसन टेस्ट। सो वी विल इंपोर्ट द फाइल। Now in this particular importing the file, there is from text two options. So now I will take the base one. I will select the file from the desktop. The name of the file is durbin-watson-test. And this particular file, I will be giving it to you in the description. I will give the link. Now I will just write strings as factors because we need at least factors for this. And I will import the data. Meanwhile, I will rename this file so that I can give you the script file. So what I can do is I can say save as, let's name it as durbin-watson-R file. Save it in the desktop. Once I do this, you can see the name will come here. Has come. Now what I can do is I can install the packages which I want. Install dot packages. I need the package lm test which I have already downloaded, so I will not, I will make it as a comment. But when I am going to give you the file, I will remove this comment. So I don't want to run it again and again. Only one time you have to run it. Now I can do lm. It is a base function lm stats. And we can see this particular command over here. Let me copy this. Control C and put it here. So let me change the file name to data frame 1 df1 and view df1. I can remove this. I can delete all this. Rename it and just run these commands. Control enter. Now we have df1. df1 has experience, age, leadership, salary. Salary is a dependent variable and experience, age and leadership is independent variable. The Durbin-Watson test is for time series data, to check is there any autocorrelation in time series data, panel data, or in the regression models. So autocorrelation in the data is checked by Durbin-Watson test. Durbin-Watson test will take the regression model as its input. So let us use the regression again in this. So what is the regression? Salary, we have to regress salary. Salary is predicted by experience, age, and other independent variables. So TF1, you can write $, and everything will come here. Friends, why I am doing like this, I can write salary also, but then spelling mistake can be there, S can be small, A is there or not, many things are there. So it's better to do like this. If you remember the variable names, it's okay. Otherwise you can do in this way, it is a good trick. DF1 $, I want to predict salary by experience, plus DF1 $. Let me copy. See, so $, age, plus control V. Okay, it's not coming like this. No. Yes, and what is left? Experience, age, and leadership. So we have all these things. So let us remove these df1 $. Why I did like this? This is not as per rules, but I was finding many times when I did this programming, when I'm doing like without any support, my spelling mistake is there. Sometimes E is not capital, even that will make a difference. It should be exact. So I choose the system, and then from system I will select and then remove the dollars. And whatever is the input of this linear model, I want this to be put in data frame, new data frame, DF, say, one is already there, two, and press enter. Oops, there is a mistake. Object experience not found. Okay, it is not found because we did not mention the file name data is equal to, what is the file name? DF1. Control enter. Now if you see here, okay, we go to the environment, we have DF2 has been there. So DF1 is there, now DF2 is there. DF2 is what? It is the input of the model. Whatever is the result of this command, it is in DF2. If I write summary DF2, control enter, I will get all the session statistics. See all those coefficients and everything has come, but today I'm not going to talk about this. Our aim is to find Durbin-Watson test, autocorrelation test. Now already I have installed package lm test. Now I will call the library. LM test, control enter. You know what is the advantage of these libraries and packages? You must be thinking it is tedious, but it is good actually. If you see R is a big program, R is a big programming language. If everything is included in the base, then your computer will hang. It's very difficult. It will take a lot of memory. So advantage of R is that whatever you need to do, you can download, you can install those particular packages only. So if you have a low-end computer also, R will work perfectly in that. And if you have a very big data also, R will work perfectly in that, because it is using only those libraries. When I say library LM test, it has taken it in the memory. Till that time, it is not there in the memory. And when we are installing packages, once only we have to install the package, not every time. And after that, I have called this LM test. Now it is in the memory. I have called it. So just a small brief about R. Now let us do Durbin-Watson test, DWS. It is coming, library is LM test. And what is the input it will take? As I told you, it will take DF2, the regression model summary. So DF2, control, enter. Now we can see that Durbin-Watson test has been written over here, and DW, that is the test statistics, is 2.14, p value is 0.8, and this is all about Durbin-Watson test. Now what is the conclusion, or what is the things we can see from here? Now this particular article I liked. It says that Durbin-Watson, in practice, if D, that is the test statistics, Durbin-Watson test statistics is between 1.5 to 2.5, indicates there is no autocorrelation. So what is our figure? It is 1.5 to how much? 2.5. Actually state saying that 2 is no autocorrelation. Less than 2 positive, more than 2 negative. But in practice, exact 2 will come. It is highly impractical. That's why statisticians are using 1.5 to 2.5 range for no problem. There is no autocorrelation. But beyond these limits, there is a problem. Either it can be positive or it can be negative. So like if D is greater than 2.5, it indicates negative autocorrelation. If it is less than 1.5, it indicates positive autocorrelation. So this particular link also I will put it description, control C. Now other thing which is saying this particular article, just for your idea, see this, there is no autocorrelation in two or some limits, that is the critical value. For 95% confidence, say these are the critical values. Up to this, there is no problem, there is no autocorrelation. Beyond this, either positive or negative. So this is the concept which I have told you. And what is this DU, DL? These are the upper limit of the critical value, and L is the lower limit of the critical value. So as you know that when we are checking hypothesis, there are two methods. One is p-value, another is critical value. That is a region, there is a range. If it is in that particular range, it is okay. But beyond the range, it is not okay. That range is decided by critical values. So this is what that critical value, upper limit, lower limit, it is saying. So let us see our example. It says that p-value is 0.87 and Durbin-Watson test is 2.14. So as per our idea, 1.5, you see this article, 1.5 to, what was it saying? Let us see it, 1.5 to 2.5, there is no autocorrelation, means there is no autocorrelation. So this is within 1.5 to 2.5. So we can say there is no autocorrelation. as per the tester durbin-watson-test. Now what about p-value? Many people ignore it, but let us see it. P-value is 0.87. P-value should be less than 0.05. That is the hypothesis testing rule. We have confidence interval of 95%. P-value should be less than 0.05. You have to reject the null hypothesis. So if p-value is more than 0.05, less than or equal to 0.05, we reject. If it is more than 0.05, we FTR, fail to reject the hypothesis. So in our case, it is what? More than 0.05, we fail to reject the null hypothesis. So what is the null hypothesis for Durbin-Watson test? This we see this, and here it says if we fail to reject the null hypothesis, if p is greater than 0.05, and we can say that there is no autocorrelation. P is greater than 0.05, we fail to reject null hypothesis, and we can say there is no autocorrelation. So both ways, by Durbin-Watson test amount, the number, it is within the range of no autocorrelation. P value is also saying there is no autocorrelation. So we can say that in our model, linear regression, linear model, this particular linear model, there is no autocorrelation. Thank you very much for watching this video. Aur dosto, main chahta hu ki aap mere video ko like kare, share kare, aur mujhe bataen ki aapko ye kaisa laga. Aur agar aapko koi aur topic ke bare mein bhi janna hai to please aap mujhe bataen. Thank you very much for watching my video.